Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It is an honor for me today to present to you my colleagues, Katlyn Allison of Carmichaels. She is our reigning coal queen. And I just had someone ask me if there's a coal king. So just to be clear, it's the King Coal Association that hosts the pageant in my district that chooses the coal queen. These young ladies are so talented and so beautiful, and it is so competitive each year, and Katlyn is our reigning coal queen. She is the 18-year-old daughter of Todd and Lisa Allison and the younger sister of Andrew Allison, and her family is here with us today. If they would please rise, and if you would please acknowledge Katlyn's family. Thank you so much. Katlyn is a senior at Carmichaels Area Senior High School. This fall, Katlyn will be attending Slippery Rock University to major in biology with aspirations of becoming a physical therapist. She is a very busy young lady. She is the vice president of her senior class, a member of SAD, the ski club, and a member of the National Honor Society, of which she holds the position of secretary. She also sings, dances, plays the piano, and is the drum major for the high school band. Katlyn's out-of-school activities include being a member of the Green Valley Presbyterian Church, where she is a teacher for the kindergarten church. Katlyn's youth group and the Pittsburgh Project combine their resources to help the elderly and less fortunate to make repairs to both the inside and outside of their homes. Also, she traveled this past summer on a mission trip with Meeting God in Missions to the Dominican Republic, where she met and spent a week with some amazing villagers who touched her heart and changed her life forever. Katlyn's family has been involved in the coal industry for many generations. Her great-grandfather was the general mine foreman at the Robina Mine No. 3. Her grandfather worked for U.S. Steel at the Robina Mine in Alicia and the Dilworth Mine in Races Landing. And her father, Todd, was employed at Hatfield's Ferry Power Station, a coal-fired power plant that unfortunately was shut down. After 21 years of his service, the plant was closed in 2013. Katlyn feels very strongly about the importance of the coal industry in our area and our country's need for this natural resource, because coal does keep the lights on. I also want to acknowledge the Coal Queen Pageant Committee in the rear of the house, Becky Mitchell, Patty Pratt, who also happens to be the Coal Queen's aunt, and Jean Hockenberry. If you would give them a round of applause. Thank you, committee. I want to thank you, my colleagues, and it's my honor to present Katlyn this house citation. And if you could give her one more round of Harrisburg applause. Thank you.